Going into the Halifax City Hall, July 27th. Let's try that again.
You only got 5 seconds.
You need to put a buzzer on it so I can hear it.
Yeah, no, it doesn't hear too well, but
okay. Yeah, when cars go by and stuff, I'm not going to hear anything.
Yeah.
Even when you opened it, I couldn't even hear it. I won't be here very long, but no, yeah. I got the door.
Okay.
I'll hit you if I come in. Okay. Nice weather.
Well, yeah, it's beautiful.
What time does the light with this City Hall officially close? Like 4:30?
Yeah, I locked the door at 6.
Oh, okay.
But well, mostly everybody's gone by that time.
Yeah. So, is there an MLA or anybody in right now? Doesn't matter where they're from in Halifax, as long as there's somebody I can talk to. What I'm here for is about what's happening at the Halifax Commons. They're putting in the rotaries and they're cutting down all these 500-year-old trees.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, they've made a mess because they just cut down all the wind wall. When they build fields, farmers, everybody does this. You know, you need a thing to cut the wind off, and they just cut the trees down. They're creating a nightmare for the neighborhood.
Yeah, hi Ken. I have Daniel downstairs, and he wants to talk to somebody from council support or any councilors or anybody from upstairs to come down and chat with the Halifax Commons. Yeah, they're doing that roundabout up there.
The rotaries.
Okay. Yeah, great, thanks. Give up, bye bye. Relax, somebody's going to come down.
I was a developer in Toronto, eh?
Right.
Not only that. I'm a lot smarter than most people want to admit, and when they hear an intelligent person speak, they like to attack you, and because dumb people always do that.
Yeah.
But you'll hear what I have to say. What they're doing over there, it's not just about the trees themselves, it's what they're doing to the neighborhood, what's going to happen without the trees there. In wintertime, the snow drifts are huge that come off that field. That's why they put the trees there. And the old guys had common sense, and they knew when you build a big flat field, you got to have a windbreak. They just cut the trees down. You know what's going to happen to the streets in that neighborhood? They're going to be coated in snow and ice all winter long. They won't even be able to keep up with the snow drifts. I live right there. It's right in front of me, the commons. They just created a huge nightmare by cutting down these huge trees. So.
Oh, hey, Lynn. Yeah, sure, hang on.
Oh, no, she has to come down.
Yeah, she's got to talk to you on the phone.
No, I can't.
You don't want to talk to her on the phone?
It's too uncomfortable. I'm moving my arms around. It's too painful.
Well, I see she can't talk to you on the phone.
I can do it for I have a hands-free phone from my phone.
Can I talk? Goodbye.
No, I can't hold my arms up. This is a prosthesis on this side. Everything's broken, right? That's why I have these armrests.
What's that on the side? Wheelchair rights.
Wheelchair rights. Yeah, wheelchair rights is got all the reports of pertaining to Halifax.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of reports, and they ignore everything. Just like that sidewalk they built over in that corner there, that new one they just redid.
Yeah.
See the slope of it, right? On the other side of the mall, right, opposite corner of the City Hall. The slope is like this, curled. Impossible for a wheelchair to drive on that. Anybody in a wheelchair that gets on that slope is going to lose control of their wheelchair. Because if you build a wheelchair ramp and it goes down like this, but if you slope it, the wheelchair is going to go right off the ramp.
Yeah.
That's what they built there. That is deadly. Deadly, 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 deadly. People are going to die over there. If I ever hit my wheelchair on that ramp, I would slide right onto the street. Because I have casters on my chair. People think I'm driving a car that I can steer. There's no steering on a wheelchair. There's a balancing act is all it is.
Hi there.
Hi.
How are you doing?
Not too bad. I'm Daniel.
Hi, Daniel.
Hi.
I think I saw you one night at...
I meet a lot of people. I'm going to back up so I can see you better, because I got a neck brace on. It's hard to move my head around.
Sure.
I am so disappointed at what they've done to the Halifax Commons, and what I'm really disappointed about is that they didn't have any sense. You have anything to record this? Because you can't. You must be a fast writer.
I am.
Oh, good. Okay. So anyway, over the years, I live right in front of the Halifax Commons. Okay. So, and I'm in a wheelchair, so snow and ice and things like that really affects my life. And I have big giant trees in front of my building.
Yeah.
And even with the big giant trees, now here's the problem. Here's the thing. When I heard from neighbors and different people in the neighborhood that they were planning on developing the intersections and putting in rotaries, well, they lied to everybody in the neighborhood about that one they're working on right now.
Okay.
And what they told everyone is that they were only going to put one road in instead of two. The park was going to get bigger because they only need a tiny little rotary because there's no traffic there. Instead, what they've done is they're building a gigantic rotary that you would expect to see in a really, really busy location. There's no cars at that corner. There's no traffic. There's nothing. I mean, all day long you look, even there's never any rush hour. There's nothing. Nobody uses that road. So anyway, a couple of days ago, I go out and I look and I realize, wow, look at that. They're cutting down all the trees. And giant 500-year-old oak trees, they're cutting them all down. Every single tree around on both sides of the park are cut down now. And then they're going to do the other corner. And then they're going to do the other corner. So I'm doing a report myself, okay? I'm putting it on my website. I've been doing photos and everything and explaining to the world what's happening. And I've talked to the people that are running the project, Extra Construction and everybody, because I was a developer in Toronto and I've done lots of reports in this town. I do know how real estate works. I especially know that because that's what I worked at in Toronto, as real estate.
Mm-hmm.
And when you do things in a city, when I was in Toronto in North York, if every time we wanted to build something anywhere, because Metropolitan Toronto is huge, so we had things happening everywhere. And I was the young guy that was super genius, so I always went to, I ran the whole business. So I would go to city council, I would go to city hall, I'd get the zoning change if it could be done. I would find out, and I'm the one that did all this stuff, because they knew who I was. And people, when they talked to me, loved it, because I always spoke intelligently. I never went in to be an antagonist or a troublemaker, but now I speak loud because I can't breathe well because I'm all destroyed. But at the Halifax Commons, as I was watching this and I'm realizing, man, you know, this is unbelievable. So I did my interviews yesterday. I talked to people. I didn't record most of the interviews. I didn't want to. I just wanted the information. So I've been doing this for 2 days. And today I went back and I told the lady that runs the project from Dexter Construction. Now, she's really nice. And it's really terrible when a city hall or a provincial government doesn't listen to the people and only listens to the corporate interests that only care about money. Because that's what's happened at the rotary there. You don't need that giant rotary. It's a huge waste of money. But here's what they did that's really, really stupid. I told them, I was there yelling at them just now, telling them this. I said, anywhere in the world where they build a big giant field in the middle of a city, you're never gonna see that anywhere in the world where they don't put trees around the edge for a windbreak. I told them, I said, do you know what's going to happen to these rotaries and these sidewalks and these roads around the park now in the wintertime? Because when those trees were growing and were built, the houses and buildings were really small. And if anybody builds a big building in any city in the world, they have to do wind tests, okay, to see how that's going to come out. Well, here it's a little reverse. They changed the terrain and never ever stopped to think about the wind and what that's going to do when it hits the buildings instead of the trees. And even in the winter when there's no leaves on the trees, like, these guys have got to be really stupid not to know what I'm about to tell you. Common sense is really simple. Even when the wind hits the tree in the winter and some of it blows through, when the wind hits a tree, it slows the wind down. The wind goes up over the tree and the rest of it curls around and the snow piles up there. And that's how snow fences work. That's how they do it for deserts. They do it all over the world. Everybody knows when you've got something that's going to fly off of the surface of a field, you've got to have a windbreak. They cut down these gigantic trees, 500-year-old oak trees. All the trees are gone, right? They didn't leave any. And I said to the lady, do you know what's going to happen to this neighborhood in the wintertime now that you've done this? You're going to have the biggest snow drifts constantly, day and night. And then when there's no wind, snow on the field, the roads are going to be sheer ice. I live right in front of the commons. I look out my window and I see it. I've seen the snowstorms that go through in winter. And for me in particular, it really affects me because if the wind's blowing, even when it's not snowing anywhere, I can't go out because the sidewalks are covered in snowdrifts on the other side of the road where the trees are. And I can't go anywhere. But where I'm at, where my building is, that doesn't really get covered because the trees have already stopped the wind from hitting my building. When the Halifax Commons was, the properties were being developed, now you've got a whole bunch of huge condos all around there, and they're talking about taking down, did you know that they're actually doing this? Behind the scenes is a bunch of people that are conspiring to cut down, to tear down all the ancient homes in that neighborhood. They actually told me they were gonna do that now, it's in the plans. They're gonna widen the roads to meet up with these big, giant rotaries that they're building. And there really is a conspiracy on to destroy these oldest homes in North America. The guys actually told me, yes, it's gonna happen. That's why they're building these giant rotaries, because I asked them, why build a big rotary when there's no cars that are gonna use it? They said, well, that's not our problem. We're gonna widen the roads and take all the houses out. That's their plan. And I don't know if the city knows about that, if they're conspiring against the people, because the people in that neighborhood are listening to me, and I talked to them, and they're finding out. Well, I told them, I said, why would you build a giant rotary that can handle 150,000 cars an hour when you don't even get 100 cars an hour at that intersection? You go there any time, day or night. I've got videos of it. There's no traffic. There's never any cars there. Like, all you need is a small little road, little tiny rotary, that's it. And that's what they said they were going to do when I asked them about this last year. They said, no, the trees aren't going to get cut. The park is actually going to be getting bigger. They're going to give back to the commons, which is actually, the roadway is built on the commons. But remember the one rule about the Halifax Commons and why it belongs to the people, not the city, not to anyone else, is that it was given to us by Queen Victoria under one stipulation, that it's for the common good. And what they're doing to the park right now, that's not going to be for anyone's good except for the corporations that are going to make a lot of money off this project. So this is really, really serious, okay?
Do you have a phone number?
Yeah, 719-0008. Don't tell anybody who I am, because there's a lot of people that don't like me, because I'm really smart and I really speak well and I write reports and I publish them. And so the criminals and the people that are not honest are always the ones that are gonna attack people. Honest people don't attack anyone, and I don't attack anybody. But I swear to you.
Tell the counselor.
What's that?
I can give the counselor.
Well, you can, but you're even gonna have some counselors that talk behind my back, because I've already tried to deal with City Hall before. I used to do it freely in Toronto all the time. I could go in and I was always welcome. I even did it in Ottawa when I lived there. I went and walked apartment buildings and I talked to people. But I don't have that two-way communication here. I'm not here because I'm trying to, for my ego or for anything else. I've done one thing all my life. I've always cared about people on this planet that we live on. And everything I do is not selfish. It's because I care. And I only try to contribute to the good. That's who I am. But in this town, it doesn't work that way. There's a lot of really bad people that are in governments here, okay? It's really not good at all. There's no democracy here. So when they lied to the people in our neighborhood about what their intentions were about the rotaries, well, I talked to a lot of people old like me and activists, and there's a lot of organizations in that neighborhood, and I've already talked to a bunch of people. Not one person was ever told they were going to cut the trees down. And people asked, did the city ask the people if they wanted those trees cut down? You never even asked anyone. It's our trees, it's our park. The people that live in that neighborhood were never conferred. So these big people up above in the city hall, or not city hall, in the province and everywhere else, okay? Remember, when I was in Toronto, I dealt with people like this. I even ran an election in Toronto. I am really powerful because I speak truth. And me, I'm not afraid of anything anymore, okay? My health is really bad. And you know what? Nobody, I don't care who they are, isn't gonna intimidate me, because I'm not here for my own good. I'm here because common sense has gotta come back. And I tried to remind people that the Halifax Commons is where common law was born. Common sense was born in companies, not corporations. And Canada wasn't born in Ottawa, it was born in Halifax. And people don't know that either. And they don't realize that our parliamentary democracy was technically the first representative parliament in the world, not just in it was the first one. Something beautiful was born in Halifax. The whole world admired Canada for 150 years because it was based on common sense and common law. And here you are, here they are, coming to the Halifax Commons, where Canada was born, where democracy was born, where real freedom was born, all based on loving and respecting other people and the environment, and all based on truth. And here they come, tearing the park apart. People in the neighborhood are literally crying. People are putting flowers by their tree trunks because they can't believe anybody in this city would allow anyone, when we've lost so many trees and all the storms that have come through here. How on earth could you take the flagship park of Halifax, the very heart of the city, and cut down all the big trees around it? You know how bad that is?
They're gonna plant a bunch of new ones, Daniel.
It doesn't matter. You just cut down all the windbreak they need to keep the wind storms from happening on the streets. That's why the trees were there. They were a windbreak. There's no more windbreak. See, here we say, oh, we plant new trees. I don't care if you plant little tiny trees. They're gonna take 500 years before they be beautiful like that. See what I mean? And I've heard people say that. And you know what else? There's another problem happening all over the city. If you look up close at all the trees, People are in such in denial, it's amazing to me. People, it's right in front of their face, and they won't admit it to themselves or anyone else. You look at the very trees in front on your property. The one on the right, you can look at that one. Go look at the bark. It's coated with a material that looks like paint. Look at the leaves. They're all burnt and shriveled up. That's happening everywhere in Halifax. And not just in Halifax. It's happening all over the planet. Trees are dying everywhere. Mm-hmm. And here you guys are cutting down the most magnificent, gigantic trees that have lived for, that can live through storms. And all the little trees that they grabbed from the middle medium of the road, they planted them in the park. They're all dying. They're all sick. And you know, I have a website, and it's actually called, I'll give you one of my cards, and you can do this on your own, because politics can't handle me. I'm too smart for them. I'm not kidding you. They can't handle a person that speaks like me. I have a website called the Fukushima Radiation Tree Reports. Because last year, I had another, I'm still up and running. It's called Chemtrails in Our Skies. But I've done it for 3 years. I've documented right up close. I'm a really, really good photographer. And I got blogs and websites all over the world. I'm read by everybody. And these people that get elected don't respect intelligent people when they walk in the door. Because intelligent people will always make them look incompetent when they are. Intelligent people are always going to shoot them down when they're wrong. It's not like I'm attacking them. You want to be a politician, you better have a lot of virtues and a lot of values, and that only comes from being strong, and the only reason you're strong is because you're a truthful person. Because only truth empowers an individual, nothing else does. Rest is a bunch of criminals that live for money. The trees they planted all around the commons that they took off the barriers are all dying, and they're all going to be dead very soon. The bark is all cracked open on them. You go to my website and you look at all the close-ups that I've done in the last 3 years and the reports that I've done that I've read all over the world. When I publish stuff, people send me messages and they show me what's happening in their country. And ever since Fukushima, we are in desperate situation. Fukushima is plutonium, and people don't know what that is. They don't understand. Plutonium is the most deadly thing on this planet. And if that goes out into the environment, it goes into fission immediately. Mm-hmm. And fission never goes out. So we have radiation floating everywhere in our environment. Mm-hmm. The trees in front of the city hall, go look at the coating. Do it on your own. Go call up some scientists. But you know what? The cover-up is worldwide. The mm-hmm. cover-up is huge. They don't want to talk about this stuff, and I'm publishing it. So I'm sitting here. Every day I go out, I see more and more trees dying. The Halifax Public Gardens, when the Prince came in, I photographed it all. They went in with every city crew truck they had, and they cut down all the dead trees and all the dead branches because they were everywhere. There was huge, gigantic piles everywhere. That's never happened before. And as now, you go back over there now, there's a whole bunch of other dead trees now. But there's something else wrong at the public gardens. And remember, I've done reports on all these things. And my reports can't be denied by anybody except for the people that don't want to go and look. At the Halifax Public Gardens, you have another big, potential, deadly situation. Radiation, okay, it does a lot of different things, but sometimes trees get hit with a beam of radiation that will literally burn a hole through it. And a lot of the trees at the public gardens have big holes in them, little holes, you can see them, they look like a bug, but it's not a bug, it's radiation. That's how powerful radiation is. And there's a whole bunch of trees with these holes, but there's something else happening. You'd have to see all my reports to understand what happens. When radiation hits the bark of a tree, it starts poking holes in it. And you're noticing around the city, a lot of trees are little sprouting little branches out of the tree trunks and all around the base. That's the radiation that does that, because it pokes holes and the sap comes out, okay? That's happening everywhere, and there's more. It doesn't end, okay? But at the public gardens, since you've got people that are gardeners over there, which don't have a clue about anything except how to plant something in a greenhouse, you know, just like the guys don't know about a big open field. There's not a farmer's field in the world that doesn't have windbreaks. You have to have them. Otherwise, the wind is going to put you out of business. At the Halifax Public Gardens right now, you walk around, or you can look at my blog that I've already done, but I'm going to compile it together, because you actually walk around with a powerful camera like I have. You can zoom right into the holes that are in the trees and see inside the trees. Even when I'm like hundreds of feet away, I can do this. About 15 of the trees at the public gardens have huge, gigantic holes in them. And they're empty on the inside. The radiation literally just burnt right through the whole tree. You've got 15 big giant trees over there. You better tell your tree guys to go over and look inside the holes, because they're going to realize there's no tree on the inside. A good wind is going to knock these trees down on buildings and on people. And I'm not a crazy lunatic. I'm telling you that you better get a message out to the crews over there. Go look inside the holes. They're hollow. There's no tree on the inside. And in Toronto and other cities, whenever a hole developed in a tree, they immediately filled it with concrete so the tree wouldn't keep deteriorating. They didn't do that there. They don't know how to take care of trees. So anyway, you've got 15 trees there. I have all the photos, I've done it. And there, these are giant holes. You look at the hole and there's nothing inside the big trees. The trees are gonna fall over on people very soon. And there's a lot more than that. I mean, everywhere you look, the trees are all sick and dying. We have a really big problem. And the problem in this world is this, it's very simple. What's causing all the harm on the planet is that everyone lost their common sense. And remember that common law and common sense was born right here. And I did a speech at Albany Landing the other day. And people that know me came over to ask me questions publicly because I answered them. And they set it up this way. I didn't know they were doing this. Another thing they didn't understand is why was there 10,000 people at Albany Landing on Canada Day? They've never had that many people there. The streets are completely filled. They couldn't understand what happened. And I didn't think much of it, but people knew I was going there. And well, here's what actually happened. They started asking me questions. I did a speech for an hour and a half explaining the history of Canada and what's happened to this country. And while I was talking, everybody in the crowd was silent. Not a person made a sound, and there was no music playing for over an hour and a half. You ever heard of that ever happening at Albany Landing when the bands were there and they're not playing? That's what they did when I was speaking, because they actually came over to have me speak about the history of Canada. I was a politician in Toronto. I ran a federal election. I do know the history of what's happened to this planet in Canada. And why I came to Halifax, because something special was born here a long, long time ago. And I've told all the people in universities and everyone here, we need to re-wake that up, because if we don't wake up, the only thing that this planet's ever seen that ever worked, which is common law, which was done by beautiful, honest Christian people that believed in truth and love, that's how this place was born, out of people that had real value and real virtue. You're letting the corporations dictate to the governments. You're letting the corporations lie to the kids and the people in the schools, the books they produce, on television, everything. Corporatism is the disease that's killing this planet. Remember, the nightmare started with Trudeau shutting down the Bank of Canada's function, and people think that when you create money, you have to make it. No, it's just a number in a bank account. The corporate criminals own the banks that have taken over our country. We don't have our own bank anymore. So the corporate criminals produce fake money in a computer number on a computer screen and have used that fake money to corporatize the whole country. We had no corporations before. We had companies based on common sense and common law. So that's the kind of speech I was doing at the waterfront. And I had CBC Radio, I did a speech for an hour. The guy recorded. By the time I was done, he couldn't barely hold his camera because he realized what I was saying to him and I was saying to everybody that was there. And I've been doing this all my life. I did speeches in Toronto. I was a politician. But right now, I'm at the point in my life where it doesn't matter if somebody wants to kill me, because you know something? Somewhere on this planet, the spark of truth has to be woken up again. And it happened once here, over 200 years ago. Tell everybody you know the history of Halifax and make that spark happen again. Common law and common sense has got to come back. And when I was on the waterfront, I told everybody, you got to do one thing. You got to take all the corporate criminals out of our governments.
I'm going to have to stop. I know. Somebody's waiting.
Okay. Remember, at the public gardens.
Yep.
I mean, at the commons, without those big trees there anymore, they're never going to be able to keep those rotary sidewalks and roads clear, because even when it's not snowing, the wind's blowing. Yeah. They're going to have to send city crews there every single day, every few hours, to keep clearing the snow drifts. And little tiny trees they put in there aren't going to stop any of it.
I gotcha. I wrote it down.
Yeah, it's a really, don't let them do the other rotaries, because they're going to destroy the whole neighborhood.
I gotcha. It's nice to talk to you.
Oh, hold on.
Yeah. Thank you. I'll get up there.
You know what's amazing about truth, though? If when I meet people that don't know what I'm about to say, it doesn't intimidate me or bother me, because I know one thing. All good human beings are the same. When you hear truth, you may not know what it is, but good human beings will listen. And you know what happens with that? Is that eventually a healthy tree of life will grow the seeds of truth. And that's how all thinking works. And that's what wise elders should do with young people, is teach them truth. And a lot of times they wouldn't believe you. But you know what happens with people that are intelligent? They have respect for intelligent people. I'm not an idiot. I've never been an idiot. But I don't get treated with any respect by politicians, because they all have corporate interests. And if the mayor, you know, he knows me, Mr. Savage, right? I've talked to him. Yep. I've got his card, right? Let him know I was here, okay?
I will.
If you need the photo shoots and the videos of the situation, I'm actually working on a report right now.
Yep.
And it's got some of it in there. And when it's done, you're going to have everything an Indian engineer needs to know. But common sense will tell you, you can't cut down the big trees, because now the wind's going to hit the buildings.
I gotcha. Thank you.
The park is finished anyway in that corner. And they don't clear the roads to begin with. So, man, people are going to die driving around there. Take care, guy. Listen, have them put a little buzzer on the lock thing.
Yes.
All right, thanks. So do you guys live in Halifax? Do you live near the Commons? No? Okay, let me tell you a little something and tell everybody. This is really important. Hold on a second. Just give me like 2 minutes. Over at the Commons, what they're doing right now is they're putting in rotaries around the outside of the Commons, but they made one major mistake. Anywhere in the world you go, when there's a big field, even the farmer, everybody knows this, you've got to have windbreaks. They just cut down all the 500-year-old trees, cut down all the big trees. That I live right in front of the Commons. Every winter, there's nothing but whiteouts coming off. And the big trees, they stop the wind and the snow falls in the field. They cut the trees off. Now you've got big buildings there. They're never, ever going to be able to keep the sidewalks and roads clear of snow and ice. The high winds are going to turn the surface to ice when there's no... Even when it's not snowing, even a week later, the snow's still covering the... Man, I can't believe they cut down the wind shear. Those developers that did that have got to be the stupidest people in the world. The trees weren't there for decoration. They were actually put there on purpose to cut off the wind. It's devastating that in the neighborhood, what they're doing. Yeah. And no one's going to be able to drive safely, because the city of Halifax is going to have a depot right there at the corner, and the guys are going to have to keep coming out every 10 minutes clearing the snow. That's how fast the roads will be covered in snow. They'll never be able to keep up with it. It's the biggest mistake that's ever been done in Halifax. And people are going to die, and it's going to cost us a huge fortune to figure out how we're going to keep those roads clear from now on. You have no idea the nightmare they just created. I live right there, and I was a developer in Toronto, and I just talked to those developers over there, and I told them, you guys have got to be the stupidest people in the world when you don't realize the common sense that goes behind building a field in a city. You got to have a windbreak. And the buildings were really small back then. And even with the big buildings, the wind hits the trees, even when there's no leaves, you get turbulence, the snow falls, the other ones go up, and they always went over the houses. Now, without any trees, it's going to hit the buildings, the turbulence is going to be on the street, even when it's not snowing. Can you imagine the blizzards and storms that are going to come through, what that's going to do without the trees there? But you know what it feels like to see these beautiful, gigantic oaks and everything cut down? They got to be insane. This is the most horrible thing I could ever imagine, that anybody in this city would want to cut down some of the oldest trees in Nova Scotia, and they were built on the Commons where common law was born. Canada was born on the Commons, not in Ottawa, here. What happened to common sense in this country? Take care, ladies. Well, that went well. I got to speak to a few politicians. And you know what? They're absolutely terrified of the fact of what I just told them. It's so true. Without the trees there, it is going to be impossible to keep the roads clear. I told them, you're going to need a depot right there with a bunch of trucks that are going to come out every 5 minutes because the wind is going to keep replacing the snow. It's going to keep piling it. When the snowplows do it now with the trees there, they can't even keep up. Without the trees and the wind hitting those big buildings, those roads are going to be undrivable. The people are going to die there now. Man, you can't have a giant field like that with no windbreak. All the world, all the farmers, all the fields have windbreaks on them. They all know what the wind does if you don't stop it when it hits an object. Airplanes, you know, all the engineers know. Anyway, guess what? 29 minutes. You're going to be published online. The wise guy that I met here with the gray hair. Take care, man. I'm turning off the camera now. Oh, for the least that are listening to this thing, go to truesoldier.com or go to canadiansituations.wordpress.com or just go anywhere on the World Wide Web and stay away from corporate sites and start waking up and open up your mind, because realize we're in a lot of trouble because you're not helping. This is Daniel Towsley, as you know already.